We're now looking at a live feed of Maggie's brain. And what we've done is we've taken that alpha wave frequency and we've turned it into a color scheme. And so what you see is as the alpha waves come and go, her brain is turning more or less blue. And that's just the more blue, the more alpha. And I mean, it just turned the brain a little so that we're not hiding any part of the brain from you. You can see the whole thing, right? So one of the ways that you can actually evoke alpha waves is to close your eyes, because you reduce the amount of visual input going into the brain. And then when you do that, the brain relaxes. And then you'll see alpha wave activity go up. So in a moment, I'm going to ask Maggie to close her eyes. Okay, now, close your eyes. Okay, a massive increase in the alpha waves and the brain turns blue. And open them. Okay, should we test our luck and just do it one more time just because it's so cool? Okay, close your eyes. Massive input, blue brain. Amanda and Maggie. So here's the takeaway. The changes we saw in Maggie's brain, they weren't subtle. She closes her eyes. I mean, we all saw it. And so we can use that information. The brain leaves clues. As you change your mental state, the brainwave patterns will change, and we can identify that. There's other things which will change as well. So I can tell whether you're relaxed or stressed. I can tell whether you're focused or your mind is wandering, even when you don't know, just by looking at this kind of information. And so you can see, if we want to do metrics, benchmarks, process flow analytics, trying to understand your cognitive state, we can use this technology to do that.